Hey guys, it's Kelsey. Welcome to my channel, or welcome back to my channel. So today we're going to be doing a fun little video where we take a look at all of my tattoos. Yeah, I'll show you guys all the tattoos that I have in the order that I got them in, and then give you guys a little bit of inside scoop on the tattoos that I want to get in the future. It is addicting, that's a fact. So let's just jump on and get started. So to start off with the first tattoo that I ever got, it is a teeny tiny tattoo. It is on my finger. You can see, I'll insert better close-up pics, but this is tiny, like literally this size of an ant. And it is just a little equal sign on the inside of my finger. And this tattoo is really, really important to me. I got it when I was, I wanna say like, 18 or 19. I got it like a few years ago. I'm 22 now. And I don't know, it is really important to me. It's just kind of goes like with my values, I guess. It's just like how important equality is to me in like all shapes and forms. So yeah, I don't know. It's kind of a personal tattoo. I just really like it. I really like finger tattoos, little things like that you can just like see throughout the day. And just like be reminded of the things that you value and hold close to you. So yeah, it's just kind of a small little tattoo that no one would really, I don't know, no one really notices it that often that I know of. I have only ever had like one stranger be like, oh, you have a tattoo? When I used to work like at a cashier, this like one customer was like, oh, you did a little stick and poke on you? And like, honestly, it looks like that because yeah, one line is definitely thicker than the other, but I just went into like a random tattoo shop with my friend that I think she had gone to that tattoo shop before, or she had just like heard good things about it. I just trusted her, and we went in, we just like walked in, and I like paid way too much for it, and the girl was like really rude about it, and not a great experience, but I love the tattoo, and that's all that matters. So yeah, that was my first tattoo experience. It was a little bit jarring to say the least, because I don't know, I just didn't know anything about the shop. The girl was like, we don't do finger tattoos. Like, she thought that I was like trying to get like gang signs or something, and I was like, I'm just trying to represent equality, you know? So I had to pay like $100 for this like little tic-tac thing, and then I think she ended up actually only charging me 80 after she like yelled at me about having to pay 100 for it, and I was like, yeah, I'm fine with that. So anyways, my second tattoo, it would be my second largest one as well, and it is this one on the back of my arm. I'll give you guys a little bit of a close-up to this one as well. And this one I got like 2-ish years ago now, roughly 2 years ago, and I got it for my mom because it is a B, and as you can see there's a little D initial underneath it, and my mom's name is Debbie, or her full name is Deborah, which means bee in Hebrew. So yeah, it's a B, and then the D is for Debbie or Deborah. And yeah, I don't know, it's just a special tattoo. I got it, I think in like October or November, and then I was going to like hide it, you know, since it's winter and you're wearing long sleeves and stuff, and give it to her as like part of her Christmas gift. And then I got her this like snow globe with like bees on it and a little engraving as well. But I forget what happened. I had to like run upstairs really quick one day, and I was like in a towel, and then she's like, excuse me. It was like already healed. I had it for like a month, and I was like, okay, Merry Christmas, I guess. But yeah, I don't know. It's a really special tattoo to me. I got it from this one. I did a little bit more research on as far as like actually picking an artist and a studio to go to. So I found a girl on Instagram that used to be in my city. I don't think she is anymore. But I went to her, Vanessa. I'll have her, all of the artists that I talk about listed in the description box down below. But yeah, I went to her for this piece, and it was a pretty decent experience. It only like took like 20 minutes, and I was like really, really shocked at how quick and like simple everything was. But yeah, I don't know, I really like this tattoo. The only thing with the placement is that like I never really see it. Like I only ever see it if I'm like catch a glimpse of it in the mirror or maybe in a picture, and I'm like, oh yeah. But I do love it. I just wish that I actually got to look at it more often. And then after that, the next tattoos I got were 3 small ones all at the same time. I went with Jaden to a tattoo artist that he had gone to before, and he was actually getting a really large tattoo at the time, and it was part of my birthday present, was it, Jay? That you gave me that certificate? Yeah, he gave me like the cutest little certificate ever. I'll actually try to find it, and I'll insert it here. It was so sweet. It was like he like made this like certificate saying that I got to get a tattoo for my birthday. So that was really cool. I got, like I said, 3 small ones, and then he got his large one in the same appointment. So it was really nice to be able to do that together. And I got another finger tattoo. I got this tiny little question mark. Again, I'll give you guys a better look at it. And then I got this little light bulb on the inside of my arm here. And I got one on my knee. Small on the inside of my knee here. I'll give you guys like a better close-up look at that as well. So I got the question mark on my middle finger, which is does have some meaning to it, but I also just really wanted some more finger tattoos. And then I found a little bit of meaning in this placement. So it is a question mark on your middle finger, and it's supposed to like kind of symbolize, you know, to maybe like question things before you hate on them, which is like something that I'm like always trying to work on. Like the fact that I just started watching PewDiePie and the H3H3 podcast after like years of thinking that I just wouldn't like them. So yeah, we're working on it, you know? You just have to like not write things off so quickly is basically what I'm trying to get at. But yeah, so that's a cool little thing. And again, I just really like seeing it like day to day. Finger tattoos are really nice that way, especially when like they're on the side, like you don't really see them like on my hands like this, but then you still see them when you're doing like day to day activities, which is like really cool. And then I got this little light bulb on the inside of my arm. This one's kind of like just for fun. You could say that it's like for creativity and all that kind of stuff, but I just think it's cute, honestly. And I remember like when I first got it and then I like woke up the next day and I had my arm bent and like the light bulb was like crooked, and I was like, oh my god, it's crooked, like what the heck happened? And I was like freaking out, and I was like, oh wait, I just have a little chubby arm, I just gotta straighten my arm out. So yeah, I don't know, that's kind of funny. And then I got just a little sketch of the word, or like a little kind of doodle style letters of the word art on my knee, and that one's just kind of like for fun too. I don't know, I don't really feel like you need to have like really deep in-depth reasons as to like why you get your tattoos. If it has like a little bit of significance to you or you just really like it, then go for it. So yeah, I mean, some of mine do have more important meanings than others, but I guess speaking on to that comes my next tattoo, which is my last tattoo, my biggest tattoo, and my most I just wanted it. So that would be this one on my arm here. It's my before I forget, I actually got 4 little tattoos when I went with Jane that one time. I don't know why I forgot about this one for a second, but I got these little Roman numerals on the inside of my arm. It is Roman numeral 7. 7 is like my favorite number. It's come up in like my life a lot. I'm born in 1997 on the 7th. And I just really like that number. I don't know, it's just always my favorite number. And I wanted to get a little Roman numeral tattoo, and I was getting a lot of black tattoos, and I was, I don't know, interested in getting color tattoos, but I didn't want a huge commitment, so I got this one in red. It was like actually very impulsive for me to be like at the tattoo shop, and I was like, actually, let's just do that one in red. So yeah, I don't know, I'm really really happy that I got it in red. I think it looks really cool. So yeah, after that I got my last tattoo, which is my biggest tattoo, and it is this leopard on my arm here. You can see, and it kind of, it's like in the same area as my Roman numeral tattoo. I love this angle of it where you can see them both at the same time. I just think it looks really cool. And yeah, this is the leopard that I got. I got this one in April at the tattoo expo in town. It's kind of funny because we went to the tattoo expo and I ended up getting a tattoo from a guy that tattoos in Saskatoon. Which is also another artist that Jaden has gone to. So yeah, I ended up going to a Saskatoon artist for this tattoo. It's Joe Shedden on Instagram. I'll have him linked in the description box down below. And then for my other small 4 tattoos, if I didn't say it before, it was done by Alfie, and I'll have his information in the description box down below as well. And then as far as future tattoos that I want to get, I do have a list of tattoos that I would love to get, but they are expensive for my, current income at the moment. So yeah, we're gonna be waiting on that, but I do definitely have a few that I want. I know I definitely want to get one on my upper arm here because I have my panther here, and I want something kind of on the inside here to kind of balance out this arm. And I do know what I want. I want something, well, I kind of know what I want. So I want like a Roman bust or like a Roman sculpture. I studied a lot of art history in school, and that's like a subject that I'm really passionate about. So I'm not exactly sure which sculpture I want to get yet, but I have like a style of the tattoo and like the kind of idea in mind. Something like kind of like this, but maybe even like a, I don't know. I don't know which one I want yet. But yeah, I'm not sure exactly which sculpture I want yet. I'll have to like go through and look again, but I'm trying not to look because then I'll just be like, okay, like, yeah, I need that like right now, and like I just can't do that right now. So yeah, I know that that's a tattoo that I want. And then I don't want to go into too much detail on all the tattoos that I want. It's like kind of like, you know, picking out like baby names. You're like, okay, like I can't tell anybody until like it's official, you know, like until it's like yours. But I do know that I want to get one that is like kind of like a portrait, but it's like a more like just like an outline portrait of my grandparents. There's like a really cute picture we have of them from a photo booth, and I have like the style and placement of that one all planned out. So that's another tattoo that I really want to get. And I have a signature of my great grandma Hazel, which is my middle name, and I would really like to get that signature script, probably like on my back or on my arm. I'm not sure yet, but I know I definitely want to get that. And I'm sure there's like quite a few little tattoos that I'll end up with. I know I do want to get a small swallow as well. And I don't know, there's probably going to be like lots of other ones that are kind of random, but I'm into it and I'm excited. So, but yeah, that's basically it for all the tattoos that I have. Again, there's lots of other tattoos that I want to get in the future, so I'll probably have to do an updated version of this video sometime. If that's something you guys would like to see, then let me know. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video from me this week. If you guys want to see more little sit down videos like this, let me know. I'm going to try to get some more videos up for you guys for the month of August. I'm hoping to be able to do more than once a week. I've just been kind of a perfectionist and filmed some videos and ended up throwing them out because they weren't good enough. So I don't know, I'm like kind of torn on what I want to do right now. I don't know. I want to do like really high quality stuff for you guys, but then I also want to post frequently, so it's kind of hard, you know.
Also play Minecraft for a year.
Yeah, and I also just like want to lay down and watch Netflix and play Minecraft and just like, you know, go into a coma before I have to go back to school, because it feels like I've been in university for 2 years straight and I'm ready to drop out. I've also thought about filming a chit chat get ready with me where I just, you know, vent to you guys about all of these types of issues. So let me know if that's something you want to hear about. But yeah, so again, hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please subscribe if you're not already. It really helps me out. Give this video a thumbs up. And I will see you guys very shortly. Bye.
Are you still there? To delete your message, press 7. To save it in the archives, press 9. To hear more options, press 0.
What are you talking about?